The power of young fools lost. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The power of young fools lost. You see, the young fools lost is so powerful. The loss of flesh is so powerful that they have pulled so many people down today. Even so many great men of God yesterday. The power of lust have taken them down. Because flesh is so powerful. There is so power in flesh. That is where sin lies. That is where temptation comes from. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So brothers and sisters, for we not to fall, for the power of youthful lust not to take us down, this is why we need to be very careful in the life we are living right now, because flesh is so powerful that if you are not careful, it can take away your anointing. Even though you are anointed and you are born, it can take away your anointing in a second. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus. So
Hallelujah.
Our Bible is reading from 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 22. Hallelujah.
I praise the Lord.
The power of young fool lost. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So our Bible is reading for 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 22. And I read, the Bible lets us to know, it says, flee also young fool lust, but follow righteousness, faith, love, peace, with them that you can call on the Lord, with heart of a pure heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So brothers and sisters, the Bible is letting us to know there, let us flee from evil desire of the youthful lust. Praise Master Jesus. And pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace alone. That is the only way that we can call the Lord with a pure heart. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
But with those who call the Lord without a pure heart, they cannot see the Lord in the time of help. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When any of this, the young fool lost, today we are desire to do our will. We are desire to do what we want to do, but not the desire of God in our life. We are lost. We want to make money. We want to do anything by ourselves. We want to take it by ourselves. We are lost into the lust of flesh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we forgot that there is power on it. And if that power of that flesh holds on to a man, it can fall the anointing, it can destroy a man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is why it's so powerful. It's so powerful because he's in the flesh. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we should not lost in that, the lust of flesh. But if we are lost on it, the power on it can bring us down at any time, any day. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So he's telling us to flee away from every evil desire of young fool lust, so that we pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace all alone. That is the only thing. And this is the only way we can call the Lord with a pure heart, and he will answer us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, without all this, so brothers and sisters, if we are not having all this in our heart, we cannot call the Lord and he will answer us. This is what the Bible is telling us here in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 22. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And the Bible let us to know in 1st book of John chapter 2 verse 16. He said, for all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life is not of the Father, but of this world. Meaning, for everything in this world, the carving of sinful men, the lust of his eyes and the boasting of what he has done. He comes from what? He does not come from what? The Father. But from what? From the world. The world, that is where the flesh lies. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
All this does not come from the Father. But if we allow them to take over us, they can destroy us at any time, any day. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The only way we cannot be pulled down is when we pursue righteousness, faith and love and peace. That is the only way we can be seeing the Lord always. But if we allow the things of the world to take over us, I tell you, we are bound to pull down at any time. Even though you are loaded with the armors of God, the armors of God in you can be taken away by the lust of flesh anytime, mm-hmm. because it's so powerful. Mm-hmm. Flesh is so powerful. Even though you are loaded with the armors of God, mm-hmm. you are burning fire. Mm-hmm. That fire can quench a minute. Mm-hmm. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So we have to be very, very careful. We have to be very careful because there is power on it. It's so powerful. It's so powerful. Today, we are young into the lust of flesh. We are so desired to go into the world, to do the things of the world, to do it by ourselves. The young pull up. Today, look at the youth out there. You say a little boy, counting money, because you don't know what they are doing. If your eyes is open, you see young people sowing their hands in blood to make money. Killing souls to make money. I tell you, brothers and sisters, killing souls to make money. Young children these days to make money. All this are not happening in the whole. In the past generation, all this does not happen. But this time around, you see young people can steal to make money. Those days they will say court. What is court? You only see old people in the court. But today, children, youth these days are the owner of court.
Mm-hmm.
Youth these days are the one even sowing, even dealing with blood, issue of blood, when you talk of sacrifice. But those days, no young person can talk about blood. But these days, the youth are lost against the things of the world. So they are ready to do anything to make money. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So brothers and sisters, the Bible is letting us to know here in 1st book of John chapter 2 verse 16, for everything in the world, the carving of sinful men, the lust of his eyes, and the boasting of what he has done comes not from the Father, but from the world. So all these things are not of the Father. They are of this world. Praise Master Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And when you read further there, you see what the Bible is saying in 17. That anyone that lusts on this one, they are not of the Father. The love of the Father cannot dwell in them. Do you see? The love of the Father cannot dwell in you. When you are lost into the youthful lust of this world, the love of the Father cannot dwell in you. Because those things are not of the Father. They are of this world. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, brothers and sisters, that's what the Bible let us to know in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 5. It said, not in the lust of what? Completion. Hallelujah.
Mm.
Oppositions. Praise Master Jesus. Even as the Gentiles which know not God. Meaning in portions. Hallelujah. In position lost, which have lived like the earthly people. The earthly people, the people of the world are the Gentiles. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He said, not in what? Not in what? In passion. Lost. We shall what? Live. Not in the passion lost, we shall live. Like those people, the earthly people, which are the Gentiles. Who what? Who does not what? Know God. But like they live the life that pleases them. But living like God, who has not called us to what? To impure, but to live as an holy life. To live a holy life. To live a holy life. That is what God has called us for. God has not called us to live in impure life, but to live a holy life. That is what he has called us for. So, brothers and sisters, if we must carry to the end, the Lord is letting us to know, we must flee away from sin. We must flee away from idolatry. We must flee away from immorality. We must flee away from every evil. If not, if we are carrying anointing, I tell you, we can be pulled down at any time. Whatever we are doing, if we want to be seeing the Lord, we have to run away from the lust of this world. He lost in the flesh. That is where the temptation comes from. That is where the sin hides. That is the power of Satan. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, brothers and sisters, the Bible lets us to know in Psalm 78, verse 18. Look at what it says. It says, and they what? Tempted God in their what? Heart by asking me for their loss. After, when you read that, you will see what the Bible is saying there. They were willful. Mm-hmm. Put God in test. The children of God, look at what they were doing. They willful put God in test after what they have did to him. Some of us, this is what we are doing today. We will still see. We still have the boldness to ask God for blessing. We still ask God, but we forgot that what we have done to God. Now look at what they said here. When you read that, you see, they meaning they willful put God to test.
Mm-hmm.
By what? Determined for the food. For food. They have calves, but they spoke against God, saying, can God still spread a table in this time of distress? Because they know what they have done wrong. They know what the lustful flesh has taken them to do to God. Flesh lost. He made them to do what they did to God. And now they are saying, can God still spread a table in this time? Can he spread a table for us? You see, when one sin against God, you refuse to acknowledge the sin. God cannot spread a table for you. But they were still putting God willingly. Look at it. Meaning they were willful, still putting God in test. Demanding for something from God. Putting God in test. I tell you, when the anger of God comes down that way, you cannot bear it. You cannot bear it. When you forgot that you are sinning against God, you are not taking God as a little boy. Look at what the Bible is telling us here in Psalm 78, verse 18. They willingly put God to test. Putting it to test after what they know in their heart they have done to God. Rebellious children. They are everywhere right now. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, brothers and sisters, you and I, if we must carry on, if the Lord must hear us, he's telling us to pursue righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
Pursue righteousness. Because the power of youthful lust is so powerful. There is power on it. There is power. There is power. There is power. It can pull anything down. It can pull you off at any time. It can pull your spiritual life at any time. You become nothing.
Mm.
We have to be very careful. We have to be very careful. Look at the world today. The so-called pastors out there, unknowingly to them, God is no longer with them. But I tell you, they are still doing what the children of God did here. They are still asking God for blessing. They are still doing it.
Mm-hmm.
They are unknowingly to them. They are willingly putting God to test by demanding for food from God. When they know that they are no longer for God, they know it deep in their heart. They know it, but they don't want to confess it. So that people in the congregation will not go away. So that they will not say, this great man of God doing this, not be me, I run away from this church. So that the church will not just dry up overnight. But is it not better? Is it not better God disgrace you and embrace you again? That you are being embraced by Satan, tomorrow it destroys you. Is it not better? But they don't want to bear it. They don't want to bear it. This is what the Bible is telling us. They tempted God. Many are doing it out there right now. They are still asking God, demanding for God, bring blessing to me. Bring blessing to me. And they know it deep in their heart. They are no longer with God. They don't want to confess it for people to know. They are drawn away because the power of young fools have got them down. The power of lots of flesh have destroyed them. And made them to run to Satan. And made them to Satan have succeeded, holding them back. Praise Master Jesus. So, brothers and sisters, let us be very careful. If the Lord must set the table for us in time of distress, we have to be very careful. We have to search around if we are okay with the Lord. If we are okay with the Lord, no matter the anointing we have, no matter the anointing you have, no matter the anointing I have, that it does not matter to God.
Mm-hmm.
When sin comes, you are far away from him.
Mm-hmm.
You become like a man that is frustrating. That is what the Lord said.
Mm-hmm.
the power of youthful lust. No wonder you have been frustrating. That person becomes frustrating. Things will no longer work well. If he speaks, you will see that he's speaking on his own. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus. So, Amen. Brothers and sisters, let us be very careful. The Lord is speaking to us this hour. We have to be very careful right now because the power of this earth is taking over right now. The ruler of this earth is taking over. How does he take over the power of young fellows? If you lost it to his desire, he take over you. Both even anything in desire in anything. Hallelujah. So let us be very careful, brothers and sisters. The Bible lets us to know in the book of James chapter 1 verse 14. It says, but every man is what? Tempted. When he draw what? Away of his own what? Lust. And enter into it. Now, this is what the Bible is telling us. He says, but each one is tempted. When what? By his own what? Evil desire. By his own evil desire. Immediately you desire to go on your own way. So do that thing on your own way is an evil before God. Because God is not on it. He becomes an evil. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He becomes an evil desire. He becomes an evil lust. He who designed a way. That is what the Bible is telling us. He designed a way and enter into it. Meaning he draw it away. He will design it. He will enter into it. Then, after his desire has conceived, meaning after that his desire he has committed, then what happened next? He said he give birth to what? Sin. Meaning he has committed sin. He has just committed sin before God. That is what he said. He give birth to sin. Meaning he has just committed sin. And when what? When sin fully grow, he give birth to what? Death. Meaning when he have not confessed. When he don't confess that sin, it will lead to death. Meaning when sin fully grows, it gives birth what? To death. Meaning when you refuse to confess that sin, it will take you to death. It will end that person to death. Many today they desire to live and die instead of them to confess their sin. That is what is happening to many pastors out there, many people out there, many children of God out there. They rather to cover their sin with pride than to confess it. Even though God still tells them, go and confess your sin, I will still be with you. Nalai. Go to the congregation, confess the sin you committed. Instead of that person, that pastor, to confess his sin, he will rather keep it. He will still be committing more. Let even God speak to a member in the church and go and meet the pastor. Pastor, this is the word of the Lord. The Lord says you should return back to him. Otherwise, the rod is coming against you. He will cover his ear. If God is not taking, send the pastor away. He sent it away out of the church. He will not want to confess that sin because he don't want it. He will be thinking of his reputation. Oh, my reputation. Oh, the congregation. Oh, what about all this congregation? If they hear this sin now, they will all go. You are looking about yourself. But you forgot, if you fall down and die, we go to hell and suffer that sin again. But it doesn't care. Even though you come and say, this is what the Lord said, he will tell you he has not sinned. He has not committed any sin. He will still be covering up that sin. Many pastors out there today, they sleep with members. Members will get pregnant. They will still do abortion, a pastor. After that, even though the Lord said confess your sin, what he just did, he just take and lay straight fire to the altar. Confess your sin, he will still deny to confess the sin. A member will be caught in the church. Instead of going on some session, he will go and open his own church. He don't want to confess his sin to God. Brothers and sisters, let you and I be very careful. If we want to be with God, if we want God to be with us, the Lord is letting us to know we should pursue righteousness. Loving him more. and let the peace reign. That is the only way we can call the Lord, he will answer us. So that we will not be like the children of old, what they did in the psalm where we read. The willingly people seek God to test by demanding for food after when they know what they are doing in the lust of flesh. What they have done to God. They have put God into test. They are put into test. Don't put God to test. Don't put God to test. Otherwise, the hunger, nobody can bear it. Nobody can bear it. If you put God to test, you cannot put God to test because he's not a man. He's our Father. We have to be very careful. We have to be afraid of who we cannot see. But today, men are rather too afraid of who they see than the God that they don't see. Why are we like this? The Lord is letting you and I to know we have to flee away from love. He can destroy. He can destroy. He has pulled down many anointing right now. He has pulled down many anointing and he's still ready to pull down many. And you and I will not be a part of it in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So brothers and sisters, for we not to be a part of it, the Lord is letting us to know, let us be very careful. Let us be very careful. Even though, brothers and sisters, the Bible let us to know in Romans chapter 7, verse 7, he said, what shall we say then? Look at it. Question. The Lord is asking us, what shall we say then? Question. Is there law? See? Question. Is the law sin? God forbid. The law cannot be a sin. God cannot bring a good thing to us. We begin to say, it's not a sin. The Bible says, God forbid. He answered himself. He said, I have not known sin, but by the law, for I have not known the law, except the law has said, thou shalt not what? Convert. What is Paul telling us here? Now, Paul was telling the people here in Romans 7:7, and the Lord is using the mouth of Paul to talk to you and I at this hour. What shall we say to all these brothers and sisters? Is the law of God sin?
No.
Let us answer it in our hearts. And the Bible is telling us now, certainly no, meaning God forbid. Indeed, look at what Paul said, meaning, indeed, I could not know what sin was, except through the law, for I could have not have known what conversion really was. If the law has not said, do not convert, do you see it? Paul has not known all this. But when he knew, from the day he gave the life to Christ, look at his mission he carried to the end. And when you read, you see that this is an evil thought. This is an evil thought. He have not known all this. Paul have not known all this. But when he know, the law has made, that is what the Paul is telling us here. He said, if not the law has not said it, if the law has not said it, he has not known what is the meaning of sin. He have not known except through the law. He have not known what conversation means really was until the law said it. Can the law not be a sin? The one that has come to correct us, he cannot. We have to follow it. We have to follow it and take what the Lord is telling us every day so that we grow and reach to the end as we have prayed and carried to the end and follow the Lord on the last day. But if we allow the power of youthful lust take over us, I tell you, we are bound to be in the world. Not inside the word of God again. We will not be following the word. Yesterday, we are soaking ourselves in the word of God. Where will we find the true word? But today, we forget it and follow the word. And I tell you, the word will also take over that person on the last day. He will still remain in the word. The word will consume that person on that last day. While the one that follow Christ will still go and inherit the kingdom. And I pray the kingdom will bring our portion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So, brothers and sisters, the last we are just taking at this hour, the Bible lets us to know, now, Paul has said it, now we have known it. What do we need to say then? The Bible said to us, this I said then, Walk in the Spirit. What do we need to do now? What do we need to do of this, brother? Galatians 5:16 says, this I said then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not walk for fulfill the law of flesh. This is where it lies. The power is in the flesh. The power is in the flesh. The power of youthful lust is in the flesh. By the time we walk in the Spirit, meaning he says to us right now, say I said, live by the Spirit, and you what? Will not what? Create the desire of the sinful nature. The desire of all what? Sinful nature. The desire of what? The sinful nature. The desire of what? Lustful flesh. If we don't walk in the Spirit, it's bound to take us down. I tell you, brothers and sisters, the Lord is telling us this hour, even though you are married, even though you are married, it's just a privilege given to us. The Bible says a man does not have a right over himself, so also a woman. That is a privilege, not power. Not power you have given to us. The Lord is talking to you, talking to me, talking to every one of us. Not power you have given to us. Because some of us today, some women even get married so that they can be even be doing that thing every day. Some men get married so that thing will be done every day. But the Lord is like, it's not by power, it's a privilege. So it's not power given to us. It can also destroy our anointing. If we want to carry it to the end, we have to be free from it also. If you are a woman, you are a man. You are a man that carry anointing, you are a woman that carry anointing. Please, brothers and sisters, let us flee away from youthful lust. It can destroy our anointing. It can make us to be frustrating. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Even though you are married, it's good to be married. Oh yes, that's why the Bible says, marry. After you marry, it says that a man and woman does not have power over yourself. Good. That is it. Not a power.
Mm-hmm.
That is the privilege. The Bible could have not said it. That is the privilege. When you read it, that is the privilege given to us. But not power. Not power. There is difference between a privilege and a power given to you. When you have a privilege to do something, you give glory to God. But not the power given to you to be doing it as you like. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, brothers and sisters, today I see that many of us, we want to get married so that this is my husband. Nobody will say I'm fornicating. Nobody will say I'm adultery. I'm sleeping with another man's wife. Or I'm sleeping with another man's husband. He's my husband, he's my wife. So I can do it 10 times a day. I tell you, you are still sinning against God. You cannot serve God that way. You cannot serve God and you cannot see the face of God. It's an evil. We have to flee from it. It's an evil desire. We have to see flee from it. You cannot pursue righteousness that way. It's my husband. It's my wife. I can do it as I like. Brothers and sisters, I tell you, you cannot pursue righteousness. You cannot be doing it and pursue righteousness. You are bound to just fall totally. But I tell you, even though we are married, oh yes, we are married. We have wives, we have children. But the ones that are single, let us be very careful. Away from the lust of flesh. It's so powerful. It's so powerful. That is where sin lies. That is where temptation comes from. It's the power of Satan. It's the power of Satan. But if we walk in the Spirit, brothers and sisters, let us walk in the Spirit. He said we should walk in the Spirit. Paul has told us, he has not known before. He has not known what the sin really means. What a lust really means. He has not known what sin means. He has not known what lust means. But except the law has said it. The law now said it. What is covetousness? We know the meaning of covetousness. Many of us are doing all this against our brother, against our sister today. Betrayal, evil thoughts, they are evil thoughts before God. Covetousness, pride, foolishness, pride, blasphemy, hatred, bitterness, they are evil thoughts. Fornication, adultery, they are evil thoughts before God. Look at what Paul said here. I have not known sin, but the Lord said it. I have not known lust until he said the Lord said it. Did you see? When he know what happened to Paul, Saul find a way to the Lord. He pursued righteousness. That's why, you see, everything we are just raising up right now, they are all into the prayer point we take this morning. That is why Paul was able to fight his fight that our beloved sister just read. He was able to fight a fight and fight a good fight to the end and finish his race. Brothers and sisters, we want to finish our race. Let us run away from the power of young full love so that he will not pull us down. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is talking to you and I right now. And I know the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. But I tell you, if you are not giving your life to Christ, I tell you, you are not just among of these. You cannot run any race. You cannot pursue righteousness because you are already inside. He wear you a clothes until you repent of your sin. Because see what Paul said here. He has not no sin. He has not no loss. But when he now know, he run away and gave a life to Christ after he met the Lord on the way to Damascus. Immediately, he repented of his sin. That is why he was able to run, fight a good fight of faith and run the race to the end. Today, he's wearing a crown. Mm-hmm. For you to also wear a crown, you must also know now, you have not known sin, what sin can cause to your life. You have not known what loss will bring to your life. Now, the Lord is letting us to know now, let us run away from it now. Repent of your sin today. And you have repented of your sin. You are still running inside the loss of flesh. You are still dipping yourself inside. You cannot pursue righteousness, brother. You cannot pursue righteousness. You cannot pursue righteousness, sister. You cannot. You are dipping yourself into it every day. I tell you, you cannot pursue righteousness. Immediately, it's done. The anointing is gone. So, for we to be born every day and run this race to the end and fight a good fight, the Lord is telling us we shall leave evil desire alone. Evil desire of the young fool Lord and pursue righteousness. That is the only way. That is the only thing the Lord wants us to do. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
That is the only way we can have a good heart, a pure heart to call the Lord. But if you are this, you cannot call the Lord with a heart that is not pure. You cannot call the Lord with a heart that is not pure. A heart that is not pure cannot call the Lord. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, you can still reconcile back to your Maker. We have 2 minutes to do so because of time. So that the Lord will help us. The Lord will help us and deal with the lawful flesh in our life so that he set fire on your flesh so that he pray with you and give you grace to carry on so that you can pursue righteousness. You that are not giving your life to Christ so that the Lord can have mercy on you and save you and give you salvation first so that then you can pursue righteousness. You cannot be pursue righteousness when you are still dwelling in sin. You are not giving your life to Christ. Paul did it. Look at it. There is nowhere Bible says here that Paul begins to know God. But Paul demonstrated to us now. He said, I have not known sin, but by the law. For I have not what? No law, except the law has said it. Did you see? When he find out that he has said it, he flee away from it. Then, look at what we read. This I said now. He begins to walk in the Spirit. Paul started walking in the Spirit so that he would not fulfill the lust of this flesh again. Today, he run the race. He finished his race. And he's wearing a crown. The Lord is still telling us the way we will run this race and finish it and wear a crown. This is the way now. That is the only way we can run this race. By walking in the Spirit always. You and I. The Lord is telling us to walk in the Spirit. So that we will not fulfill the lust of flesh. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Are we still there?
Yes, sir, we are there.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you are here, you give your life to Christ, or you have given your life to Christ. You want to reconcile with the Lord. Because you thought, maybe I'm married to my wife, I'm married to my husband. He just to be doing that thing every day like food. The power was given to you. No, it was not a power. It was a privilege. Because you are married. But not a power given to you. Power to be doing it as you like. I tell you, you cannot serve God that way. You cannot pursue righteousness. There will not be room for the Holy Spirit to come down There will not be room for the Spirit of God to dwell among you. So you have to reconcile back to the Lord. We have 2 minutes to do so. Because I tell you, this message, the Lord is talking to you and I right now. He's talking to you and I. The power of your full Lord. The Lord let me to know how powerful it is. How powerful it is. I tell you, I cry for mercy. I cry for mercy. I cry for mercy wherever I've been locked into. I cry for mercy. Days of war, he let me to know. I was sitting down when he said, look at it. The power of Lord, your full Lord. He can destroy anything. He can take away anointing. He don't respect anointing. I tell you. For you to carry on, the Lord is letting us to know, is to walk in the Spirit. So that we will not walk that in the desire of sinful lust of the nature. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And I present every one of us on this mountain. We are born again. And we are walking in the Spirit. We are no more in the desire of sinful nature of the lust of flesh. And the Lord will help us all in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So, brothers and sisters, and I pray this hour, every power of your full Lord, they want to pull us down, not to pursue righteousness. The Lord has destroyed them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And as we desire to follow the Lord, to pursue righteousness, faith, love, and peace, which is the only thing for our heart to be pure, to see the Lord will continue to guide us and set more fire in our flesh so that our flesh that desire that love will be dead forever in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But I tell you, if you still go back doing what the Lord, the instruction of the Lord, that the Lord has given instruction not to do, and you are still doing it, you are still inside. I tell you, you are still inside. You are running after money by yourself. The Lord cannot do it again. Let you do it by yourself. If you look very well in the book of 1 Timothy, you will see what the Lord, the Bible is telling us over there. Many that are being tempted because of money, they want to go and make money by themselves. If you read very well, you see 1 Timothy. You read 1 Timothy chapter 6. When you get home, read it very well, verse 9 to 10, and see what it is. So if you are instruction of the Lord, don't do this, don't do that, you are still doing it, I tell you, you cannot walk, you are not walking in the Spirit. If you are doing those things, you still need to reconcile back to your Father, to give you grace to carry on, to give you grace to carry on. You are deceiving yourself. If you are hiding, said you are among those that are walking in the Spirit, you are not walking in the Spirit. You are not walking in the Spirit. You are seeing the desire of the sinful lust, the sinful lust of nature. The Lord said, don't do it, and you are still doing it. Instruction has been given. You are still saying, it's only the heart that matters. As some are saying out there, my husband loved to put, he loved to see me putting on trousers. Your husband will not love you when you put on skirt. If he will love you, it's because of trousers and want to love you. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
So, if you are still walking away from the instruction of the Lord, I tell you, the power of your full love is still taking over there. For him not to take over, you have to open your mouth now and say, you are here. You are here. You want to walk in the Spirit. The Lord should help you. And he will help you this hour in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise
and I present every one of us is walking in the Spirit, and the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
This is the word of the Lord. Does the short exhortation this hour. May the Lord bless his mighty word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I pray the Holy Spirit will give us more wisdom, understanding, more for we to understand what he has told us this hour so that we work on it. We pursue righteousness so that we will not what? Fulfill the lust of flesh. Pursue more righteousness by walking in the Spirit. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you, man of God.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The Lord is good.
All the time.